the identification of stop words. So here we want to consider the importance of each word in the sentence. So as we know, English, it has a lot of filler words that appear very frequently. Like if you take words like and, a, and, a, the, so those are considered as filler words because they occur more frequently. If you take any paragraph or a page in a book, so you can find out these words more frequently. So we can say that these words introduce a lot of noise, right? So using first, we need to remove those stop words from the given text. So here, this is the output which is generated if we take the same sentence which we took before after identifying stop words. So let us remove this B. So here stop words in the sentence are is, the, and most. And the next step is dependency parsing. So here dependency parsing, it will mainly analyze the grammatical structure of a sentence. So it will find out or analyze grammatical structure in a sentence and find out related words, the words which are related to each other in that sentence. And it will also find out the type of relationship between the words. So here relationship is represented like this. So first, has one head and a dependent that modifies the head. And is labeled according to the nature of dependency between head as well as dependent. For example, if you take this. So here this is a simple dependency relationship between two words. So there exists a relationship between this car and black because this word black, it modifies the meaning of the car. Which is black car, right? So here car acts as a head. So this car, it acts as a head. And this black is a dependent. This is head and this is dependent. So the nature of relationship here is A mod, which stands for adjectival modifier. So it's an adjective or an adjective phrase which modifies the noun. So here black, it will modify the meaning of the car. So black car, white car, like that. So this A modifier, this is an adjectival modifier which will modify the noun. So like that you can find out relationship between the words. So dependency trees, they are considered as part of dependency parsing and they mainly consist of nodes as well as directed edges. So here you can see this black and car, they are nodes and this is the directed edge from car to black. And each word in a sentence that is represented as a node. So this is one node and this is second node. And the relationship between these nodes or words, they are depicted by the directed edge. So we are having directed edge connecting these two nodes. So these directed edges, they mainly indicate which word governs or which word modifies other word. So that we can get a clear hierarchy within the sentence. So how the words are related to each other. Coming to the grammatical relationships, so the edges in the dependency tree, they represent grammatical relationships. So these relationships, they define words' role in a sentence, like whether the word is subject, object, modifier, or adverb. So here you can see some relations. So subject-verb relationship. So in a sentence like, for example, if I take a sentence, she sings. Then here the word she depends on sings. and this is a representation. So she is depending on things, which is subject of the verb. And second one is modifier head relationship. So here, if you take this, the big cat. So this word big, it modifies the cat. Just like the same example, that is black cat. So here, whether the cat is big or whether it is small, so that term, it will identify the, or it will modify the term or word cat, creating modifier head relationship. So here you can see between big and cat, there is a modifier relationship. And between the and cat, there is a determiner relationship. So we already know the is a determiner and cat is noun. Next we have direct object verb relationship. So if you take sentence, she eats apples. So apple is the direct object which depends on verb eats. So you can represent it like this. Here, apple, it depends on verb eats. And here, in this case, how we got this? This is similar to she sings. You can see this, that subject verb relationship. So here, she depends on eats. And coming to modifier, coming to direct object verb relationship, this one. So the word apples, it depends on verb eats. And the last one is adverbial verb relationship. So if you take sentence, he sings well. So well modifies the verb sings and form an adverbial verb relationship. So this is verb and this is adverb. So this adverb, it will modify the verb. You can see the relationship between verb and adverb. So here, adverb modifies the word sings, which is represented with adverb modifier. Whereas in previous case, this is direct object verb relationship. So coming to the next one, that is finding noun phrases. So we need to find out noun phrases in the given sentence. So again, we can use the information from the dependency parse tree in order to find or in order to group together words that are talking about the same thing. So you need to group the words which are related to each other. So we can take the help of dependency parse tree in order to group the words like this. So if you take the same sentence, London is the capital and most populous and so on. Here you can see, these are the parts of speech tags which are assigned to every word. So remove this. Now we need to group the words. So how to group the words? So we have treated every word in our sentence as a separate entity till now. But sometimes it makes more sense to group words together that represent single idea. So we can use the information like this. So we can group the noun phrases, and after grouping them, you will get the result like this. Remove this. So we, after grouping this, the and capital, determiner plus noun, it gives you noun. So we saw this in phrases concept. So coming to most populous city, again, we combine most populous city into noun. So here it's often a quick and easy way to simplify the sentence if we don't need extra details about which words are ad adjectives and instead care more about extracting complete ideas. And step six is natural, sorry, named entity recognition. So now, here in our sentence, we have some nouns. So if you take the same sentence, so some of these nouns, they present real things in the world. For example, if you take either London, England, United Kingdom, they represent physical places on a map. So with that information, we could automatically extract list of real world places mentioned in a document. So that can be done with the help of NLP. So the main goal of NLP is we need to detect and label these nouns. So here, detect and label these nouns with real world concepts. Right? So this is how you can represent them. So London is a geographic entity. So here you can use various kinds of objects like this. See, these are some kinds of objects like people name, company names, geographic locations, like physical and political, product names, dates and times, amounts of money, names of events. So it is one of the sim easiest way to quickly get value out of NLP pipeline. And the last one is coreference resolution. So here, even though we did multiple, even though after performing multiple steps, we still have one problem. That is English. We know that English is full of pronouns, like words like she, he, it, etc. So these are the shortcuts that we use instead of writing our names over and over in a sentence. Right. So we'll just write our name at the beginning of the sentence, and after that, we'll continue with pronouns like she, he, etc. So humans can keep track of what these words represent based on the context. What about machine? So our NLP model, it doesn't know what pronouns mean because it only examines one sentence at a time. So if you take the sentence, it was founded by the Romans who named it Londinium. So if we parse the sentence with our NLP pipeline, we'll know that it was founded by Romans. But it's a lot more useful to know that London was founded by Romans. So here, this sentence gives you statement that it was founded by Romans. Then what is that it means? So you can here as a human, we can figure out that it means London. So the main goal of coreference resolution is to figure out the same mapping by tracking pronouns across the sentence. So we can do this like this. See, the result of running coreference resolution for the word London. So let us take the paragraph, and now we just use this term London two times in the sentence. But here we are using one more. We are using pronoun in order to represent that word London. It means London in this paragraph. So with coreference information combined with the parse tree and named entity information, we should be able to extract lot more or lot of information out of this document. So even we can say that coreference resolution is also one of the most difficult steps in our pipeline to be implemented. So, but usually coreference it is taken as an optional step that isn't always done. So in our pipeline, here you can see the most important steps that should be performed whenever a sentence is given, whenever in input is given. That is text document. First, you need to perform sentence segmentation. After that, you need to go with tokenization part, then parts of speech tagging, limitation, stop word removal, dependency parsing, noun phrases, and then named entity recognition. So after performing all these steps, you will get an output which is a parsed text. So this coreference resolution, it's an optional step. Right, till NER, you need to perform all the steps.